A fusion reaction is a reaction between two light atoms, typically hydrogen or an isotope of hydrogen, where the two atoms come together very rapidly and collide and bond together. And when they do that, they leave with more energy than the particles came in with. That's the energy of fusion.
One of our catchphrases that we use at the lab is a star in a jar, or having the sun here on Earth.
Fusion is important because it can supply steady power that's not dependent upon weather and environmental conditions, like some other kinds of carbon-free power are. A fusion system can make 24/7 electrical power that can be a key part of a future energy economy that's carbon-free.
It's the amount of energy, the efficiency of a fusion power device that has the potential to be an answer for alternative energy.
Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory is very important in the history of fusion research. Some of the first fusion experiments were done on this campus. Tokamak fusion test reactor made about 13 million watts of fusion power in the late 1990s. Many of the theories that we understand how plasmas are confined in magnetic fields were derived here at the lab. And a lot of basic plasma physics related to everything from microelectronics processing to the physics of the aurora borealis and the solar wind.
The work that we do here is so unique. The disciplines that you're exposed to, it's like a little of everything.
On the physics side, we have to define the parameters of fusion machines, how strong the magnetic field should be, how big they should be to achieve the research goals. But engineers have an equally challenging job, which is how do you build these things? How do you make the magnets with enough strength to make the fields but not damage themselves?
It's difficult to keep a fusion reaction running. Being able to confine a plasma so that it's dense enough and hot enough to actually facilitate a fusion process. You've got to have density, you've got to have a lot of heat to get the energy out.
If you want to use a magnetic field to confine a plasma, it has to be a donut with a hole down the middle where the magnets go down the center.
PPPL is focusing a lot of energy into our NSTXU experiment.
It's exploring a kind of configuration where the hole down the middle is very small relative to the volume of the plasma. The hole down the middle being set by this object behind me. And we are studying the physics of how well we can confine and heat and maintain a hot, dense plasma in this spherical geometry. We can then extrapolate to what a fusion reactor would look like were it done in the same kind of geometric sense.
I'm confident that we'll achieve fusion energy.
There's a lot of realm for innovation. Over the decades, the rate of improvement of plasma confinement has gone up very rapidly.
It seems the perfect solution almost to an energy crisis, but we are still trying to refine the process of actually being able to harness it as an alternative energy source that can power the grid.